Welcome back, Kingsters. So, Kings started off the three-game road trip tonight through Western Canada here against our northern nemesis, the Edmonton Oilers. Just seems Connor McDavid and Draisaitl always have our number, and unfortunately, despite even outplaying the Oilers for the better part of 40 minutes and holding a lead, we still ended up losing, 4-2 at the end, so... with that said, let's dive right into the highlights. Well, as you folks may recall from the last video, I debuted the Missing Kings Milk Carton segment, which unfortunately did include our own hometown hero, Thousand Oaks native Trevor Moore. And apparently Mr. Moore did not appreciate being on my milk carton because he went ahead and shut the Emerald City Kingster up tonight by getting the scoring started for the Kings. As you can see here, there was a nice play. The Kings win the faceoff, get it right back to the point where we get a hard slap shot off the end boards, which Quinton Byfield hustles over and throws out in front to a wide open Trevor Moore, who sinks it home past Skinner. Great hustle by Quinton Byfield, recognizing the situation with the shot off the end boards and finding Trevor Moore out in front. It's like I say, folks, the milk carton, it's about motivation. It's not about shaming anyone. We wanted to see Trevor Moore get going again, and I'm glad he took the motivation and was able to pull himself off the milk carton tonight. So, nice job, nice goal, Trevor Moore with the goal, and great assist, great work, Quinton Byfield continuing his impressive play. The Kings actually had the better part of the play for most of the first period, and they almost got through it unscathed, but then here in the final seconds, they little defensive lapse, and they let it go to the wrong guy, Connor McDavid, who is going to burn the Kings, gets it to a wide-open Hyman, who buries it past Dave Rittich, and just like that, we're all tied up with just a few seconds left in the first. Kind of puts a damper on the mood going into the locker room. And now instead of starting the second period with a 1-0 lead, we are going in tied. Again, McDavid over to Hyman, buries it past Rittich. Yep, big save Dave. Could have used a big save there. That's why big save Dave is still on the milk carton this week. In fairness to Rittich, though, I will not put that on him. That is more on the defensive breakdown. Moving on. So about 7.5 minutes into the second period here, the Kings will regain the lead, enter the zone, and we get a great pass from Kopitar over to Laferriere, who beats Skinner to give the Kings a 2-1 lead. Great goal, great pass by Kopitar. And good to see the Harvard boy get back on the score sheet. Good player and smart kid, that Laferriere, being a Harvard boy and all. I don't know if he got a peek at my bingo card or what, because he was actually slated for the milk carton. And with this goal tonight, now, he buys himself some time. So good to see him getting back on the score sheet. Good pass again by Kopitar and nice finish there past Skinner. Unfortunately, that would do it for the Kings scoring tonight. So the Kings do what you can't do here and take a penalty against Edmonton, who was just lethal against us on the power play. And Draisaitl makes the Kings pay there, tipping in the shot from Bouchard. And just like that, we're tied at 2 again. Neat little play. Bouchard, he has a rocket and he got the shot off from the point. Draisaitl's right there, to get the tip of the stick on it and beats a screen Skinner, it looks like. Just like that, we're knotted up too. So despite looking like the better team on the ice for the better part of 40 minutes, for whatever reason, the Kings had a pretty lackluster effort to start the third. And just a minute and a half in, Edmonton makes them pay. Bouchard fires the shot from the point, beating Rittich. Rittich isn't happy. He thinks he was interfered with by Hyman in front, but upon closer inspection, there was no goaltender interference. Hyman was, outside the crease, and I'm not really sure why Rittich was that upset. Perhaps just frustration. Either way, Edmonton takes the lead 2-1 here with the goal by Bouchard, and they will not look back.
So the Kings did have a pretty strong push towards the end of the game here, but in the last 3.5 minutes, Nugent Hopkins beats Dave Rittich there. Pretty goal if you're an Oilers fan. I'm not, so f*** that guy. But good for Nugent Hopkins. It was a nice goal. Puts Edmonton up 4-2, and that pretty much seals the win for them. What's more concerning is what happens shortly after this with regards to Adrian Kempe. What happens to Kempe here, this is what ruins the night. So here we have it. Rittich is pulled, extra man on the ice, right off the faceoff. You see Kempe gets tangled up and goes down. Doesn't look like anything bad, but you see he's hurting. He gets up holding his wrist and just skates off the ice. Takes a while before anyone notices, but he's back at the bench. And he's hurting. And as you see here, he's going off the ice. He's got the towel around his wrist. As they pointed out on the broadcast, usually when you got the towel on, that means there's blood. There was nothing to indicate that. It's hard to imagine. I did listen to Jim Fox after the game, and he said it looked like he possibly landed on the Oilers' stick. I don't know. I'm going to try to break it down into slow motion, see if we can get a better look. It's so hard to tell. So right out the face-off here, you see Kempe go down, puts his arm down to brace himself, and just lands awkwardly. Let me peek in on the Emerald City slow-mo cam here. So, a couple things I notice. One, you see the Oilers stick right there in Kempe's glove, which, is it possible, you know, that just smashed his fingers or hand? It's a hand injury, which again wouldn't be good. Or, and I'm no doctor, so I shouldn't be commenting, but also just the way you see his arm moves, well, like, could it be a shoulder or something? I don't know. It's hard to think so the way it's bouncing around there, but clearly he's in a lot of pain, and the outlook isn't good if you're a Kings fan. Hey guys, Future Kingster here, just jumping in for a minute while I'm finishing editing this video so I can try to get it online before the game in about an hour here. It's about 10 after 5 here Seattle time, and the Kings are getting ready to take on the Flames up in Calgary. Anyway, since I was just talking about it in the video, I see there's an update on Kempe now. He will not be in the lineup. Adrian Kempe is flying back to Los Angeles for an MRI tomorrow, it says. So, not good news. This is not what we want to hear. Very devastating about Kempe, or as my wife calls him, Hall Pass. You know what that means. Anyway, very, very, very scary times for the Kings. You know, he's our leading scorer on the team, so I'm hoping for the best, but it didn't look good. And I've watched this about 50 times, and you can't really see anything, but it's something with the wrist. And, you know, the thing with being a sniper, a goal scorer, is, you know, even if he comes back, if it's a real injury, you know, these things linger. Players come back and they're just not the same, you know. Sometimes a whole season passes, you know. Look at Byfield last year. We're like, what's wrong with this guy? And then it turns out he was like, had a serious hand injury he was battling all year. So I'm hoping it's not that serious. I don't know. But I'm trying to emotionally prepare myself that we are going to be without Adrian Kempe for a while. Possibly the rest of the season. Or the realistic reality that he may come back and just not be the same Kempe he was before this injury, at least for a while. So, anyway, I don't want to get too down. Trying to keep spirits high. We're going into Calgary. We need the win. Hopefully the boys can use this and find some motivation to pull out a much-needed victory tonight. And keep our playoff hopes alive. But, yeah, not good about Kempe, unfortunately. All right, I'll see you guys in the next one. Let's go, Kings.